Squad lunges, and you block her evade, then you lunge, and they block her evade. Same with your reverse.
Hey. So notice, when she's blocking, she's not compromising her stance.
Hey.
When she's blocking, she's not compromising her stance. Because when we get to counter-attacking, the worst thing people do is that they compromise their stance on a block, and then when they counter, they're not penetrating. If she keeps her stance from there, she's got the ability to move forward and strike properly.
Hey.
The Yakuzuki, she's got that ability to do that. So I want you to make sure you keep your posture.
Hey.
With the evading, make sure you don't step. People want to step. Just drop. Just drop. Think of MP. We just drop.
Hey.
So if we're going one side, she's just dropping. And then back up. Hey.
Hey.
The other side, she's just dropping and back up. One side, dropping, back up. Other side, dropping, back up. So it's either drop or hold your stance. Hey.
Hey. Hey.
Or mix. Mix it up. Block, evade, block, evade. About the story of David and Goliath.
Okay.
David killed Goliath, giant man, because he'd already killed a bear. He'd road tested his technique. But if I can kill a bear, I can kill a man. Road testing develops confidence. When you're training, if your partner's punching like this, it's not going to develop your confidence. You'd rather lose 20 times than succeed once, and at least you know, okay, I'm 1 out of 20. That's good feedback. So it's important that we keep control, but we need to go faster to develop our skills. And our confidence as well. If you want your partner to slow down, say go slow. But if you want them to go fast, tell them, come on, please, come in and just nail me. Or a contact fashion, I don't mind. If you're dictating, you can tell them to do what you want. We're coming in fast regardless. Her goal, she monitors her stance, and she's got to have that strong block. Strong block. Doesn't matter what hand. That confidence to be there, because if she wants to, and in a minute we'll have our counter-attack, you're in a good position to actually counter-attack.
Right?
If you feel you're already ready for counter-attacking, but we're not letting you do it yet, just do this. So you're still training your body what to do, so you're getting right back to basics and getting the fundamentals there in what you need to do for countering before you get into it.
So when you're evading, you want to make sure that no matter which punch they throw, still move to either side. So if Sensei throws both lunges and reverses, I know that I can keep coming this way the whole time. Or if I want to change, I can keep moving this way the whole time. So I'm going to move this way every time.
I'll even go low. It doesn't have to just be for head levels. Test her out. She's not warm. Pretty strong stances. So you're strong, so when you come up against these people, it can actually stop them momentarily, so that you can come up and hit. Or you can be down and hit to the groin, come up and hit.
Hey.
So pick a direction for your evasion, pick a block, ask the person to go at a pace of your choice, and develop that good strong reflex to build your confidence.